who I am today and how the city hall transformed me. So a little background information about me. I was born at the Philippines. I immigrated here about 5 years ago, but that was back in 2011, and stayed for like a couple of summer vacations spent here in the United States. I honestly didn't know how to live like an American, I guess. And I was clueless, but I was optimistic, and I was not sure about the American life. I lacked awareness and was focused solely on myself. I didn't understand why we had to move here in the United States, because I was treated like a princess, kind of princess-like lifestyle back in the Philippines. But for the sake of my parents, I was happy for them. So in the eighth grade, it was my first and last year to be a middle schooler, which is a great opportunity for me, because as I hear some of my friends moving here to the United States, they didn't know how to transition themselves into from that life to this. Like, it's just a big transition, and you really have to adapt to it like really fast, or else you're just gonna find yourself lost. So back in the sixth, eighth grade, I had difficulty speaking English because of my accent, which I still kind of have now. And I spoke proper English, which is completely different from how I speak now. So it's proper English is how we spoke at the Philippines. So it's like we use proper verbs, proper pronouns. We don't use slang. Yeah, it's very different. And my goal back then was law. So it was my grandmother's ambition. She wanted someone from her posterity to become a lawyer. It was like her ambition. It was her goal. And since I was her eldest grandchild, she wanted me to be the lawyer for the family. I was introduced. That ambition actually is what I introduced me to Swiss Hoss. So like one day in my history class, two young ladies who were professionally dressed came in, introduced themselves as people from Swiss Hoss, and they told me that it's a place for civic learning. And back then, honestly, the farthest my mindset could process is that civic learning had something to do with becoming a lawyer. So I decided to join Swiss Hoss. So on the first year, one of the very first activities we ever had was a political science bingo, which I still have now because I'm a memory hoarder, and I love the activity so much, even though the only two boxes I could sign was someone who knows someone working, born in another country and lived in another country, because I definitely didn't know what communism is, or do I know a lobbyist? No, obviously not. So I guess so it should have been a little wake-up call for me that this class was something I had to take seriously. It's not something that is just from learned knowledge, but it's mixed with common sense and with just experience. And then we had weekly articles. We had to do a summary, an analysis, and a bias. Now, I could do a summary and analysis, but I didn't know what a bias was. Even when I so carefully perused its definition, I was so lost, I didn't know. I asked Mrs. Reed for its definition, and she defined it, and I just tried to implement it. It took me about a month and a half or so to finally understand what it was and what I had to do with the article. And we had to watch the news. It was one of the most significant things that Swiss Hoss has changed in me. Like back then, I thought it was an obligation that I just had to do. I had to watch the news for Swiss Hoss. I had to be updated about every single event that is happening around the nation and even around the world. It was really tedious for me back then, but now I watch the news. I tell my parents to watch the news. I tell my grandmother to watch the news. I tell everyone to watch the news, because it's really what keeps us informed about everything that's happening around us. It's like keeping us aware. So that's like one of the shifts that happened throughout my years in Swiss Hoss, and just in my character, I guess, as a person. I volunteered for Peter Katish's campaign because there was this person who visited our program. He was a speaker from their campaign, and I guess I was so intrigued by their mission that I decided to support his campaign. And even though he didn't want, I love theater teaching. And I did call surveys so I would call people based on just a list of names and a list of numbers. Most of them are very welcoming. Some of them were, well, they didn't know I had their number and they didn't want me to call them ever again. And then we had field trips. So this is from our very first field trip. Again, remember your quarter. So it's state capital trip with Gary Hart. And then we also went to the federal and county courthouses and the large school town hall. Now these field trips were very significant to me because they prompted me to pursue, to really pursue a law career. Because I went inside and I was like, oh wow, this place is beautiful, it's gorgeous, I want to work here someday. And then for our final, it's climate change and the elections. And the significance of this is that I attained speaker by myself. I contacted Mr. Kelter from the Environmental Council of Sacramento, ECOS, for my group, and he agreed to be a speaker, so that's like a big milestone step for me. For the second year, so first semester we had speech with Cybul, and I guess this is the class where my character really transitioned, because it helped me so much with my speaking skills. So the first thing she ever taught us is to listen, listen, and listen. Don't hear, just listen. Because listening is what gives, is what, I guess, it's, I'm sorry. It builds our character and our communication skills, because by listening carefully, you have proper conversation to person and you don't get misunderstandings. So we improved our reading skills and our speaking skills. My accent improved, thankfully. And our two freshman classes were integrated. That was like one of the important things too, because freshman year we had two different classes and then they were intermixed sophomore year. So it kind of made us a family. It connected everyone. I made new friends because some of my friends dropped off freshman year, but then I made friends who are still friends now because they're still in the class. So that's like one of the best things to be as a part of this program. You would meet people who are completely different from me. You guys would have different opinions, different ideas, and just different everything, and yet you could connect through this program. Second semester, we had chemistry again with international relations, and a simple summary of this class is articles. She would give out articles, of these like thick articles, once every week, and that was like, even though they were thick and not a lot of people want to read them, I like them personally, because you would find out about such interesting facts like the My Lai incident in Vietnam, which I had no idea about. They didn't teach us that in history class. And we also learned about how China slowly spread their influence around the globe. And you don't learn that about the news. And we also went to Save the Children's V-Day. And the one thing that really struck me with this event is that I noticed how much of our age, our generation, is involved with the community. Because you would see this arena full of teenagers, of youth, that are just from every part of the state, and they come here and they represent, or they get a place in the stadium because you know that they've done something for the community. And that's not something that's available anywhere. And then I started volunteering at our academic library. I joined a teen advisory board, which further integrated and involved myself in the community. So he was our board leader, and we would plan events at the library, such as the haunted library. So that was like a great program for me because it helped me become an independent individual, and it also helped me spread my footprints around the community. And then we had philosophy. It was basically who, what, when, where, and how. We studied the ways and the philosophical ideas of just about every prominent philosopher through the centuries, and at the same time, we were learning history, since most of the ideas of these great philosophers were products of their environment. I have Cicero, and my favorite quote from him is "Live is a thing," because for me, I think that's, well, by living, we think, and by thinking, we live. And my internship. So last summer, I did an internship with our local county, Gold County Red Cross. And unfortunately, I did not finish my hours with them because they did not give me sufficient hours. Although the staff was great, they were very welcoming, but their workload was not considered internship-wise. I did pillowcase projects, and basically I went to schools and I presented to little children about what they would do in case of an emergency. And I guess it's not considered internship-wise because I didn't really learn anything in the working field. So now I'm currently under the internship at Sacramento Metropolitan of Arts under Ms. Deborah Waltman. She is our analyst, and it's basic office work, it's filing and organizing. But one thing that struck me during my interview is that under one city, she told me the entire history of SMAC from the very beginning to up till now, and she named every board member, she memorized the dates, and I was like, oh my goodness, this lady is just amazing. I was in awe of her, and I would usually go down to trips to City Hall, which is like a couple blocks away, and this further improves my independence as an individual of the community, because I did not do that before. It's like, it's a new thing for me. I would go there, I would send my idea, I tell them that I'm her intern, and I would retrieve files for them. So that's a new experience for me. And my senior project. So my senior project is split into three consecutive parts. The first is a packed grocery bag event and a little Christmas drive for mustard seed. The second, I just did this morning, is the Halloween toy drive. I've had a really busy day. And lastly is a forum advocating for the situation of the homeless. So mustard seed. So mustard seed is a private school under Loaves and Fishes that are specifically designed for children who are currently homeless and they cannot, I guess, the families can provide an actual school and education for these children, so this is where they go. Mrs. Street told me that no one was doing a project with Mustard Seed yet, so I decided to contact them. I contacted Mr. Libby first. She's the executive director of Loaves and Fishes, and she told me to contact Mr. Brian Ross, who is the director of Mustard Seed. He told me to come by sometime and to talk about my project, which is when I met Miss Stacey Johnson. Miss Stacey Johnson has been my contact over my project, and it was originally going to be a packed lunch event, but since they already had so many sponsors, we decided to transition it into a packed grocery bag event, which turned out to be a success. Just last week, I delivered 45 bags filled with food and boxes of cans, and also I decided to transition my project, to expand my project off to my sister's middle school, Sierra Oaks, K-8, and she decided that we should do a clothing drive because it's a winter season, so these kids aren't going to have any budget to, buy clothes, so we decided that it would be nice if we could donate some clothes to them. And so that was great. We had three boxes filled with clothes and five bags also filled with clothes, mittens, socks, sweaters, and even parkas. We packed the bags on December 7th. I packed it with two of my friends. They were so supporting. They're very supportive. And also, I expanded my project with Andrew Finnessy, since we're both advocating for the situation of the homeless. He funded a partial amount of the food and all of the bags with his walk-on. And the grocery bags and winter clothes were delivered December 8th, so a Tuesday. And then the Halloween toy drive this morning, seriously, yesterday and this morning. It's an annual Avid event at Rio that Simsalabim takes part of in order to successfully provide Christmas presents for the children of the Halloween school. What inspired me to do this project was back in freshman year, I volunteered for this project as an elf, because it remind me of all the Christmases I had spent at the Philippines. And it's just a lively, magnificent holiday there. It's our biggest holiday, basically. And I decided to take part of it, and I fell in love with the project. And the first thing I ever did was I contacted Mrs. Reed over the summer and told her, Mrs. Reed, I would like to do the toy drive. And then when we came back, she was like, yes, you can do the toy drive. The biggest obstacle I faced was looking for 37-inch stockings, so they're this huge. Unfortunately, the 99 cents or Dollar Tree stores didn't have them until last week, and they didn't have enough stock. What they did have was cherry covers, and I improvised out of those and made them as little bags. Our gift wrap day was December 10, which was yesterday, and we had a little problem with stuffed animals because usually we would put stuffed animals in every single bag, but this year, since we didn't get enough of those, we got a lot of presents, which we just evenly spread out, gave this class a lot of presents and the other class a lot of stuffed animals. And then the Liberty Day was this morning, December 11. The kids were so happy, I could not express it in words how happy they were. They started screaming and shouting when they saw the presents. It's been a good day. And then on January 22nd, I will be having my forum about the situation of the homeless here at Rivers Library for periods 4th, 5th, and 6th. And this is also a collaboration with Andrew Finnessy, since we're both advocating for the same cause. Our speaker would be Ms. Emily Halkin, the homeless service coordinator from the office of the city manager, and Ms. Grace Bridget with the Tubman House program. So the Tubman House program is a program for pregnant teenagers who have nowhere to go. And the mission of this forum is to spread awareness in the Rio community about the situation of these people and how we as students can help them. So basically, all of these events is what transpired me to the person I am today. I'm very thankful to the CIPS House program because I can't imagine myself as anyone else. Well, I really. And I'm showing you the video.
Yeah. screaming and jumping at you. It was a Monday.
And so that is my SipSpots presentation. That's my grandmother's wish, but actually, summer of junior year, also through my experience in SipSpots, seeing how the law field works, I decided to become a nurse, so that's a big transition, yes. I decided not to go into law, I decided to go into nursing school.
Yes.
Have you thought about voter registration efforts when it comes to the homeless? Voter registration, that's
very true. No, I have not thought of it that far, especially since I can't vote myself. We haven't signed up for the nationalization. Any questions?
Thank you,
Gail. Thank you.